Guys, welcome back. Today I am finally filming the video that I told you I would film a really long time ago, but it is basically everything I bought in Japan. Okay, actually it's not everything, it's the things that I can find that I bought in Japan and that I remember buying in Japan, because there's actually quite a lot of things that I know I bought but I have no idea where they are. But I'm sure they'll show up. So I'm going to start with non-clothing things, because otherwise I'm going to get really carried away with all of the clothes I bought. So, actually, we can start with this. The first thing is this bag. Now, I saw these bags when we went to Osaka Castle, and this lady had like, it's almost like a coloured canvas version of it. And I was like, imagine if that bag came in leather. And then I saw it in leather and it seemed like less of an original idea, but they were so beautiful. They have this little pocket at the front, two little pockets on the side, and then the way they open up is so cool. So once you open it, you literally just like push it open, and it's just like the funkiest bag ever. And you can also access your inside from the outside. I mean, that's like all bags, but you know what I mean. I can't remember where I actually bought this. I feel like it was in... oh, we were in Kyoto. Yeah, it was before we went to the Hedgehog Cafe. And they have like these shops everywhere. Like, it's hard to miss them in Japan. The brand's Anello, I think that's how you pronounce it. And they just have every color and style you can imagine. It is really, really fun. Now, I do not know what would... I did not buy this in Japan. I don't really know what we're gonna find in here, but also did not buy any of that in Japan. Maybe this can be my, like, once I've told you about it, it goes in the bag, so that I don't tell you about more than one thing once. All right. Oh, I did not buy that in Japan. My system seems flawed. I thought it was pretty good. Alright. Let's start with... oh my gosh, I forgot I had that. Oh. This is fun. This is like going to Japan all over again. This is just my journal. You guys have seen that. If you haven't, I do like a little flick through video. You can just see what's inside. I mean, it was blank when I did it, but okay. Stationery, jewelry, all that stationery stuff. Oh my gosh, I totally forgot I had all of these. I'm so excited. Where did these other ones go? Stationery, etc. things, because they feel like they don't have their own category. Oh, there was literally like nothing in that one. Okay, perfect. So, naturally, I've already given all of my presents to people, so just assume there's this plus the stuff I gave to everyone. Now, let's start with stationery, because there's a lot. So there's like paper stuff, then there is non-paper things, like pens. That's pretty much how you split this up. So the first one, which is random, but I wanted to include them because the reason we acquired these is just so cute. When we were in Fuji, this lady was like... so when we were in Fuji, we went to this restaurant and it was like a cafe that did dinner, pretty much. We had the yummiest food and the lady was so nice. She's like an older Japanese woman and she's like the only staff member we saw the whole time, and it was pretty quiet. But then when we left, she gave us these little... so she gave us... Scott and I each a pack of these. And then there was like this tiny little can of Japanese beer and like a little thing of snacks with it. And she was just like, you know, here you go, enjoy Japan. And it was so nice. But I kind of don't know what I want to do with these yet. I mean, I'm guessing Scott's not planning on using his because I have them, but we'll see. So really, oh my gosh, I've not seen this one. They're just, okay. They're Mount Fuji from different angles. So there's this one. This one. I think this is my favorite. oh no, you just saw my favorite. This one, and then this one. And they're just little postcards, and we have two packs of them. And it was just so sweet. I usually don't buy postcards when I go places, just because I'm never there long enough to send a postcard. Even though I actually really love getting postcards that have like stamps all over them because they've actually been posted. But who knows what, okay, I've made a total mess of this. Who knows what I will actually use these for. It was just so cute. I was like, I could never not find a use for these because the lady was so nice that gave it to us. Okay. Alright, the next thing I have is because it was Japanese New Year when we were in Japan, I got these from 7-Eleven, and they are the most random but cutest little envelopes. So two of them have stickers in the back, as you can see. So essentially you put little notes in them and then you stick them up. That's what I know. I imagine if you're from Japan and you know like what traditionally you would put in these, I'm guessing it's like a little Happy New Year note, I don't know, but they don't come with card. But this is like a bunch of people on a ship. There is a man with a curly staff, a man with a fish, what looks like a Viking, and then what looks like a very old man who's not wearing a shirt. I have no idea what these mean, but there's also... I just know these mean New Year. Anyway. They're really cute, and I thought I'll definitely use them. Who knows where, but I do use a lot of stationery. Like, I just write notes on cute things all the time because it's like if you've got to write a note that's probably about something not very fun, it may as well be on a cute piece of paper. And this one had Mount Fuji on it. Also, I don't have any idea what these Japanese words say, and they're just envelopes. So these are literally all just little envelopes, but I love them so much. Now for all of the pens. This isn't even all of the pens.